Our opening hymn is number 657, found in the music issue. Number 657, One Lord. Please stand.
There is one Lord, there is one faith, there is one Father of us all, and through His Son, who came to save us, there is one God living in us all. We are one body in the Lord, we are all people of His love. There is one Lord, there is one faith, there is one Father of us all, and through His Son, who came to save us, there is one God living in us all. We are one Spirit of new life. One Lord, there is one faith, there is one Father of us all, and through His Son, who came to save us, there is one God living in us all.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
To God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Habakkuk. How long, O Lord? I cry for help, but you do not listen. I cry out to you, violence, but you do not intervene. Why do you let me see ruin? Why must I look at misery? Destruction and violence are before me. There is strife and clamorous discord. Then the Lord answered me and said, write down the vision clearly upon the tablets, so that one can read it readily. For the vision still has its time, presses on to fulfillment, and will not disappoint. If it delays, wait for it. It will surely come. It will not be late. The rash one has no integrity, but the just one, because of his faith, shall live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Come, let us sing joyfully to the Lord. Let us acclaim the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us sing joyfully, sing psalms to him. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts. Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us. For he is our God, and we are the people. He shepherds the flock, he guides. If today you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massah in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they had seen my works. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I remind you to stir into flame the gift of God that you have through the imposition of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of cowardice, but rather of power and love and self-control. So do not be ashamed of your testimony to our Lord, nor of me, a prisoner for his sake, but bear your share of hardship for the gospel with the strength that comes from God. Take as your norm the sound words that you heard from me, in faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. Guard this rich trust with the help of the Holy Spirit that dwells within us. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. The word of the Lord remains forever. This is the word that has been proclaim to you. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The apostle said to the Lord, increase our faith. The Lord replied, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you would say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it would obey you. Who among you would say to your servant who has just come in from plowing or tending sheep in the field, come here immediately and take your place at table? Would he rather not say to him, prepare something for me to eat, put on your apron and wait on me while I eat and drink? You may eat and drink when I am finished. Is he grateful to that servant because he did what was commanded? So should it be with you. When you have done all you have been commanded, say, we are unprofitable servants. We have done what we were obliged to do. The Gospel of the Lord. This weekend begins the Bishop's Appeal for Vocations. The Lincoln Diocese has a good problem. Lots of good men are discerning to call to the priesthood. Now, while other dioceses have plenty of money for their fewer seminarians, we really have the reversal. We have fewer funds for our many seminarians. Other dioceses, and I have a lot of friends who I went to seminary with, they have had to, in their dioceses, combine or even close parishes simply due to the lack of priests. So with our situation, parishes are asked, can you invest in the future of the church? It's not just us giving money, but did you know that the seminarians themselves, they have to put in money as well? Seminarians personally contribute $5,000. We have a lot of 19 and 20-year-olds coming from very different backgrounds, so $5,000 is a big sacrifice for a family, for someone to enter the seminary. It's not like that in most other places, but again, we got the vocations, but honestly, we just don't have the funds. In short, I do not like financial homilies, and you're going to see this over the years. I rarely give them, and only when they're needed. But all of us, and myself included, are called to participate in the bishop's appeal for vocations. The best part is the giving is made really easy. If you prefer giving by check or cash, we have pledge cards and people manning it back on the table on your way out right there. Those will have how much you gave last year, and then you can just paperclip cash or check or at least pledge something and we'll contact you over time. But the way that I like to do it, even though I don't claim being a millennial, I'm right on the edge, I give on the website. We'll actually have QR codes at all of the exits of the church, and you can just scan that with your phone. And I like this method because it takes 2 minutes, maybe even less. So even if you've never considered or never given before, just take a quick QR code, and then as you drive home, one person in the passenger seat can fill that out. Even if you haven't given anything before, anything you give is meaningful and helpful. But let's move on to our meditation for today, because our gospel actually gives a reason on why we need to support vocations for the priesthood. Here in the 17th chapter of Luke, the apostles have just heard the same parables that you and I have been hearing in the previous weeks on Sunday. The prodigal son, dishonest steward, and the rich man with Lazarus. Jesus has been teaching them that a relationship with God is a serious thing and it's very necessary for happiness. So how do the apostles respond with this very clear warning in these parables? They actually ask for help. They said to Jesus, increase our faith. And I think a lot of people in our day and age desire this too, even if they don't know it. The world offers a life, but living that hasn't been working for us last few years. Life feels discouraging, frightening, confusing, and exhausting if we follow how the world says to live. So it's time to reject that way of life and come back to offer what God gives. With the priests of the church, there is a concrete, clear person that you can go to with your questions, your concerns, and your experiences in life. It's not always perfect. You don't always get the one-on-one time you might want. And we priests, we really do have our strengths and our weaknesses. But no matter what, when you see a priest, you feel that confidence. A priest's confidence in his truth of who Jesus was, in his love from God the Father, in his connection from the Holy Spirit, being around that can help your faith. A priest's life confidently points to Christ's presence in the world. This is where our asking for your help with vocation comes into play. God the Father is calling men to become beacons in this world of darkness, a safe harbor where you can be received and you can be accompanied during the hardest times of your life. I always felt very privileged to walk with people during their most difficult times of either doubt, during periods of them being lost, or being with them during their last moments on earth. In a lot of ways, priests are meant to be only a partial representation of God's goodness, love, and guidance that Jesus himself wants to give you. Christ desires that you can experience someone that you can turn to when you have the same desire of the apostles. When you want your faith increased, who can you turn to say, can you help? So every one of us are called to have a deep and meaningful relationship with God. However, Jesus knows the human heart. While the vast majority of people are called to marriage, which is beautiful, in the beautiful vocation of marriage, spouses, they share their love, and then with children, are called to the wonderful work of loving them, keeping them safe, and then teaching them about God and the world. So while this is going on, Jesus founded his church with the priesthood in mind, so that anyone, anywhere, at any time in history could find someone who is dedicated to the concerns of God. Now, anyone can turn to a priest when they desire an increase of faith. Luckily, they're easy to spot with all that black with a hint of white. You can go up to them at any time. At the end of this Mass, we'll have a seminarian explain his own experiences and the needs of vocations everywhere. So I'll start wrapping up here. And I know I'm donating to the Bishop's Appeal for Vocations because I need priests. I needed one to baptize me. I needed one to give me First Communion. I needed a bishop to confirm me. In the future, I'm going to need them to hear my confession. I need them to anoint me when I'm sick. And I need one to bring me communion one last time at the end of my life here on earth. Support the next generation of the church, yes, financially, but also with your prayers. Let's show the world that it's only God's guidance that is going to give the peace that everyone desires. And for us to experience peace, we need that faith. So join in the prayer of the apostles in this Mass. Ask the Lord for an increase of faith. And now, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And with all of these prayers and petitions, we offer them to our Heavenly Father.
For those ordained to serve the Church, that they will always use the permanent gifts granted by the laying on of hands, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the nations of the world, that the justice of God be not further rejected by tyranny, terrorism, and discord, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who care for animals, that they, like St. Francis of Assisi, may show kindness to all of God's creatures, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For this Eucharistic congregation, that today we may hear God's voice and harden not our hearts, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the dead, that as servants who have done their duty, that they may be welcomed into eternal life, especially for the repose of the soul of Anne Vogel, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for the needs of all here present, for which we now pause to pray. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, increase our faith, as once more we make our petitions for ourselves and for the priests and seminarians of your church. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is number 683 in the songbook. I know that my Redeemer lives, number 683.
I know that my Redeemer lives, the one who calls me home. I long to see God face to face, to see with my own eyes. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. I know that I shall one day see the goodness of the Lord, when God will wipe away our tears and death will be no more. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. The last day I shall rise again, shall be remade like God. My home shall be in God's own sight, the dying, rising Lord. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. I know that my Redeemer lives. I know that my Redeemer lives, the one who calls me home. I long to see God face to face, to see with my own eyes. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again. I know that my Redeemer lives, that I shall rise again.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of the compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your
The third Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope and James our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 337 in the songbook, One Bread, One Body, number 337.
One in the Lord.
one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And please be seated for our announcements.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Joseph Zeminski, and I'm a student at St. Gregory the Great Seminary, just south of Seward. First, I'd like to extend my sincere gratitude to all of you for your continued support and your prayers. Attending this seminary has been a really wonderful experience. It's really formed me as a man and as a disciple of Jesus Christ, and especially this seminary. In my 3 years having been there, I've seen so many men, including myself, go through this formation to really cement the truths of the faith, and also wonderful ways in order to help you, as Father was saying, as priests. And so I'd like to humbly ask your continued support, and both spiritually and financially, As Father was saying, your donations go to help the Diocese of Lincoln, to help pay the education of seminarians in both college and in the post-college seminaries. And it takes so much money. It takes thousands of dollars to get us through seminary all the way. And much of it, as Father was saying, comes from you guys and your generous support. And like Father was saying about the importance of the priesthood, it's really essential to our Christian lives. As he was saying, only through the priests we can have the sacraments, and especially the Eucharist, which is the center of our Christian life. So I'd like to, you know, encourage you guys to support, but also to take this opportunity to thank your own priests for their sacrifice and their service. Lastly, I'd like to thank you so much again for your support, and I'll be in the back of Mass, as Father was saying, back of the church after Mass. Thank you again. Bye.
Supporting the next generation of Lincoln's priests and the Bishop's appeal for vocations is made easy. For those who want to give through cash or check, please pick up your pledge card in the narthex. For those who want to use mobile giving or the website, links will be emailed out, or you can use the QR codes found throughout the church and by the exits. Thank you for supporting the priests of the future. And please join us this Thursday, October the 6th, in the parish hall at 7 p.m. to listen to Dr. Matthew Ramage speak about understanding Genesis, science, evolution, and faith. All are welcome.
Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the souls.
Our closing hymn is number 444 in the songbook, Blessed Be the Lord, number 444.
Blessed be the Lord, blessed be the Lord, the God of mercy, the God who saves. I shall not fear the dark of night, nor the arrow that flies by day. He will release me from the nets of all my foes. From their wicked hands. Beneath the shadow of his wings I will rejoice, to find a dwelling place secure. Blessed be the Lord, blessed be the Lord, the God of mercy, the God who saves. I shall not fear the dark of night, nor the arrow that flies by day. I need not shrink before the terrors of the night, nor stand alone before the light of day. No harm shall come to me, no arrows strike me down, no evil settle in my soul. Blessed be the Lord, blessed be the Lord, the God of mercy, the God who saves. I shall not fear the dark of night, nor the arrow that flies by day.
Please join in our Thanksgiving prayer. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine.
All praise and all thanksgiving be everyone and thine. sacrament most holy.